Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last lecture, we saw how to simplify exponential expressions containing terms which are multiplied together. In this lecture, we will see how to simplify exponential expressions with divided terms. We have seen that any number a raised to the nth power, where n is a positive integer, is equivalent to n a's multiplied together. Likewise, a to the nth power, where n is a negative integer, is equivalent to 1 over n a's multiplied together. So a number with a negative exponent is the same as 1 over that number with the same positive exponent. We also saw that a raised to the 0 power is equal to 1. That is, unless a itself is 0, since 0 to the 0 power is undefined. We also saw that to multiply exponential expressions with the same base, we add their exponents. Likewise, to divide exponential expressions with the same base, we subtract their exponents. We can use this last rule to simplify exponential expressions with divided terms. For example, let's simplify x to the 5th power divided by x cubed. Since these two exponential terms have the same base, x, we can subtract their exponents, which gives us x squared. Now let's simplify a numerical expression, 2 to the 17th power divided by 2 to the 14th power. These two exponential terms have the same base, 2, so we can subtract their exponents, which gives us 2 cubed. 2 cubed, of course, is 2 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 8. Notice that subtracting exponents is a lot easier than multiplying 17 twos in the numerator and 14 twos in the denominator, and then dividing. Now let's simplify the expression 3 to the 4th power divided by 3 to the 7th power. Since the exponent in the denominator is larger than the exponent in the numerator, when we subtract the exponents, we get a negative exponent, 3 to the negative 3rd power. Remember that a number with a negative exponent is the same as 1 over that number with the same positive exponent. So we can write 3 to the negative 3rd as 1 over 3 cubed, which is equal to 1 over 27. Next, we will simplify the expression y squared divided by y cubed. Subtracting the exponents, we get y with an exponent of negative 1. This is equal to 1 over y to the 1st power, which is the same as 1 over y. Occasionally, you may encounter an exponential expression with a negative exponent in the denominator. Instead of a specific exponent, let's use n to represent any exponent. We can eliminate the negative exponent by moving the term to the numerator and switching the sign of the exponent. To see why this works, instead of 1 in the numerator, let's write a to the 0 power, which is the same thing as 1. Now we can subtract the exponents, and we get an exponent of positive n. So 1 over a to the negative n is equal to a to the positive n. This looks a lot like another rule we already know. Any number with a negative exponent is the same as 1 over that number with the same positive exponent. If we switch the two sides of this equation, we can see that both equations are saying the same thing. 1 over an exponential term is equal to that same term with the sign of its exponent switched. This property is useful for eliminating negative exponents in the denominator of an expression. For example, let's say that we have an expression which contains a term in the denominator with a negative exponent. We can separate this term from the rest of the expression by rewriting the expression as a product of 1 over that term times the rest of the expression. We can then rewrite the term with a positive exponent according to our rule and recombine it with the rest of the expression. So we have eliminated the negative exponent by moving the term to the numerator and switching the sign of the exponent to positive. Likewise, we can eliminate a term with a negative exponent in the numerator of an expression. We separate this term from the rest of the expression, rewrite it as 1 over the same term with a positive exponent, and recombine it with the rest of the expression. So in an expression written as a fraction, we can move any exponential term from the denominator to the numerator, or from the numerator to the denominator, as long as we switch the sign of its exponent. Now let's simplify an exponential expression with negative exponents in the numerator and the denominator. One way to simplify this expression is to subtract the exponent of the denominator from the exponent of the numerator. Subtracting negative 5 is the same as adding 5, so we get x cubed. If you prefer to work with positive exponents, an alternate way of doing this would be to move the numerator term to the denominator and the denominator term to the numerator, switching the sign of both exponents to positive. We can then subtract the exponents to get x cubed. Now, instead of x to the negative 2 over x to the negative 5, let's simplify the expression x to the negative 5 over x to the negative 2. We swap the numerator and denominator terms and switch the sign of the exponents. Then, subtracting the exponents, we get x to the negative 3rd power, which is the same as 1 over x cubed. So far, we have used the rules of exponents to simplify exponential expressions with multiplied terms and divided terms, as long as the terms have the same base. However, exponential expressions often contain a variety of terms with different bases, which are multiplied and divided. In our next lecture, we will learn how to simplify any expression of this type.